MLB The Show's coverage of Major League Baseball is on the air. Today we've got a good matchup ahead between the Texas Rangers and the New York Yankees. It's Baseball on the Show, and it's coming up next. Jordan Montgomery is ready to go as he'll be on the mound for the Yanks. Dan, any thoughts?
Here's a guy that numbers can be a little bit deceiving. He has a whip in the 1.3 area and above range. It's a little higher than league average. He's been a little bit inconsistent, one good game, one bad game, but don't let that whip fool you. This guy's a much better pitcher than that. And if he brings his A game, he could be awfully tough in this one.
Here's Elvis Andrus now, and we are ready for some daytime baseball. Underway now in the Sunday finale as the first pitch today is taken for strike one. Well, this Yankee ball club entering play this afternoon here. They've been hot of late, winners in four straight.
Hey, Matty V, talking about a team that's on a roll right now, D-Roll. How about this? Through the first four games of this homestand, perfect 4-0. They've got their sights set, D-Roll, on some bigger and better things.
And you know what, Dan, and the fans feel it. You can tell there's an electric atmosphere brewing in this stadium right now, and hopefully it continues.
Here it comes now to Andrus.
Ball back outside.
Our game time temperature pushing up close to 90 degrees, 89 degrees to be exact at first pitch. Now Andrus with a swing and a deep drive to left. And that one is gone. How about that? A solo home run for Elvis Andrus, number 10 for him on the year. As the Rangers strike first, it's 1-0.
What a swing. What a huge boost right there. Not only does it get your boys fired up, but it kind of silences the crowd for a minute.
To the plate now, Hunter Cole.
The right fielder.
As he'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. Cole, a 6'1" right-handed swinger and thrower. He was taken in the 26th round during the 2014 draft.
I know this guy wouldn't go into the category of superstar, but to grind out the career he has, being drafted where he was, my hat's off to him.
And there are our umpires for this one. Working balls and strikes will be Mr. Darrell Parker.
Hey, not a very big strike zone, but a strike zone that kind of moves around a little bit too much for my liking.
Yeah, Dan, I know there's not a clear scouting report with Darrell. I'll tell you what, you're going to know in the first two innings where he's going to be.
Got him to miss the breaking ball there. Hunter Cole becomes the first out of the inning. And here's the former prize Dodger prospect Willie Calhoun. As he'll take a breaking ball too low, and it's 1-0. He comes in with 24 homers to his credit so far this year. That evens it up 1-1. Here's the pitch.
Looks like that bomb earlier in the inning kind of put this pitcher on the defensive, not being very aggressive right now.
To 2-2 now.
Two balls, two strikes.
Now here's the pitch. Oh, and a good curveball that time as it's taken for a called strike three, and there are two away.
This tells me a lot about this guy. He's done a real nice job bouncing back from that home run to strike out the next two guys. Sometimes you're going to get taken deep, but it's all about how you respond that really matters.
So that brings up the big bat of Joey Gallo. As he'll take a look at a pitch too low, it's ball one. And he's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for. The windup and the 1-0 pitch. Two out, nobody on. A ball and two strikes. The count now with the bases empty and two away.
Hey, nice job of bouncing back after the leadoff homer. Two quick outs after the bomb, and he's got a chance to get out of this.
The 1-2. Misses, ball two.
Pretty good breaking ball to lay off of right there. If I'm pitching, I might think this guy might be sitting on something off speed.
Bases are empty here with two men out. Now a ball lined to the left side, but this will be a foul ball. Another 2-2 offering.
Pretty easy pitch to lay off there, 2-2. Not even close to being in the strike zone. He made it easy for the hitter in that one.
Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Two out, nobody on. And it's fouled away. Once again, a 3-2. And he struck him out. A 10-pitch battle, but he finally wears him down as the inning is over. But another look here at the solo shot leading off the ball game. Bottom of the first coming up, and the Rangers are staked to an early 1-0 lead. Lance Lynn gets the ball in game three of the series. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Hey, Matt, we're getting a look at a guy that's really dependable. Last three starts, ERA just under 3.00, and that's some pretty good pitching. Minimizes the amount of walks, keeps his hits down, and if he can do more of the same of that, he should have some pretty good fortune in this one here today.
That'll bring in Giovanni Urshela. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Pitch on the way. Strike taken up in the zone. Fellas, this Rangers ball club, as they begin play, fair to say they're not playing their best baseball right now. Losers of five of their last six.
Yeah, guys, anytime you start a road trip, first five games you start 1-4, you're just trying to salvage. Do the fundamental things right. Try and sneak out a couple wins, get on the plane, and get out of here.
Lynn has registered just under 110 innings on the mound and has an ERA he'd like to see come down a bit. Starts the day in the high fours. And a big cut at the breaking ball, but he comes up empty, and that's the first out.
Big curveball for the strikeout there, and that came after an absolute missile of a fastball. Even if you recognize the breaking ball out of the pitcher's hand, it's so hard for hitters to sit back long enough after they've seen a really good fastball. Only the best can keep their hands back on those.
And that'll bring up Miguel Andujar. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. He's entering play in this one, a home run shy of 20 for the season. The 1-0 home.
Back-to-back strikeouts in the first right here. Pitcher is setting a tone, pounding the zone.
A swing and a deep drive to left. Gone! A solo shot here to left, and even 20 home runs for him now thus far. And the Yankees have drawn even now at one apiece.
Well, his offense spotted him a run in the top of the inning, and he just gave it right back. That's what happens when you plant one in a hitter's wheelhouse. Sent out of here in a hurry.
Here's the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu. And as you check out his righty-lefty splits, no surprise that he hits better against southpaws than he does against right-handers. Here's the first pitch to him.
Ball, that's just out.
Bases are empty, one man out. There's a belt-high strike to even the count at 1-1.
Hey, love the confidence in that pitch right there, going right after one of the better hitters on this team, not afraid to execute.
One and two to DJ LeMahieu.
Hey, after that extra base hit, things could go awry. He didn't. He battled right back in his zone with a nice executed pitch.
Fouled off. Just off the end of the bat, it's a foul ball, and he'll stick around. One out, nobody on. Fouled away. Now another 1-2. Comes back with the cut fastball for strike three called, and there are two down.
One thing to know is not all strikeouts are created equal. Right there, he goes down on strikes, but he really made that guy on the mound work for it. And when you're doing that in the first inning, it can have an effect on how deep he's going to be able to go into this start. There's a big difference between that and going down on three or four pitches.
And he gets ahead 0-1. His career numbers against this pitcher, he's gone 3-for-8. He's also hit a couple of home runs against him. And 1-1 as this one's in on the hands. Looking at his career totals, Judge is working with a slugging percentage over 550. So there's no denying he's one of the premier power bats in the league. Off the outside that time as the breaking ball can't catch the zone. The 2-1. High in the air out to center field. Santana is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. I think a few of these folks need to get out of the sun. More to come on the show Sunday Baseball after this. Second inning set to go, and that'll bring up the catcher, Robinson Chirinos.
The catcher, Robinson Chirinos.
Outfield shaded a bit to left center, the first pitch. And there's a base hit on the line.
Hey, just a nice piece of hitting right there. He's able to keep his hands inside that ball, stay square as long as possible, and feed it into the opposite field for a base hit.
So now to the plate, Danny Santana, as he'll fall behind here as he goes after a fastball that might have been out of the zone at strike one. That average at 291 to start the day, 11 home runs, 39 driven in. That's taken. Now it's 0-2. And on 0-2, he misses with a fastball.
Pretty standard fastball right there, 0-2. Now he's changed the eye level of the batter so he can start working something in like an off-speed curveball down in the zone.
Still 1-2 as he fouls it away.
Got to take advantage of that pitch right there. 0-2 breaker hanging over the heart of the plate. Not going to see too many of those today.
The 1-2.
Correct out. 2-2.
A swing and a miss as he picks up another one. Make it 4 strikeouts already, and there's your first out.
Boy, that's the best pitch in baseball right there with 2 strikes. That elevated fastball. Every hitter thinks that, hey, they can do something with that. But most of the time, you get the result that you saw right there. A big swing and a miss and another strikeout.
Here's Todd Frazier now. As he'll watch one miss down and in for a ball, 1-0. First swings for him in this one with a runner still at first and one gone. Now a fastball for a called strike. It's 1-1. Chirinos stands at first with one out. And that's high and off the plate, 2-1. A great curveball there, really fooled him with that one.
What I love right there is just the freedom in that hack. He ain't trying to do anything but hit the baseball as far as he can.
And he fouls this one off.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
Popped him up. Voit is over now, and he's got it for out number 2.
Batting it, the second baseman, Rougned Odor.
So a runner at first with 2 away, and that'll bring up the second baseman, Rougned Odor. As a look, now the pitch. Set to deliver the 0-1. A swinging strike, and now it's 0-2.
Man, I know exactly what this guy's feeling at the plate. Here we go again. Every time you're struggling, you look up, and it says 0-2.
Nothing in 2 count, and the pitch. Now a 58-foot curveball that misses for a ball.
He didn't look overly fooled right there because a lot of pitchers will go to the breaking stuff 0-2, but he certainly looked ready for a breaker on that pitch.
The 1-2.
He went with the off-speed there once he got him to 0-2, but now that they both missed, I think we'll see more of a challenge pitch here. You don't have to give in, but you can't be too cute either.
Runner aboard at first here with 2 gone in a 1-1 ball game. Hit down the line at first, but this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. A full count for Odor, 3 balls and 2 strikes.
3-2, 2 out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
High in the air out to center field. Gardner on the move. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. 1 left for Texas. We'll go to the bottom of the second, tied 1 apiece. Last half of the second set to go, and that'll bring up Gleyber Torres.
The designated hitter, Gleyber Torres.
First pitch coming. Here it is. And they go right after him on the inside corner for strike one. Oh, one. Here's the pitch. Fastball just misses. That's ball one.
Good fastball there. Didn't get the swing, but the guy at the plate isn't someone who chases many bad pitches.
Right there at the belt, one and two now.
Unless you're willing to sell out and try and take one part of the field out of play and just work the ball up the middle the other way, it's extremely difficult when a guy's throwing this hard to stay back on the breaking ball. You either commit and be all in on a fastball, or try and find a way to work the ball the other way to keep you back on the off speed.
Count remains 2-2. And it's fouled away. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Swing and a miss as he couldn't connect on the two-seamer, and that's out number one.
Oh, man, he's been absolutely getting overmatched at the plate the last couple of games. That's his fifth strikeout in this series alone. So clearly this pitching staff, they figured out how to attack this guy. We'll see if he can make any adjustments.
And digging into the batter's box next will be Giancarlo Stanton, as he'll take a look at ball one. Stanton just rakes left-handed pitching. There's no real way to dispute that. However, he's not nearly as proficient when facing pitching from the right side. And he gets a piece of this one to foul it toward the backstop. The 1-1. Skied into straightaway right. Cole's back in plenty of time to put this away, however, and there are two gone.
Batting seventh, the first baseman, Luke Voit.
Digging in now for the Yankees, Luke Voit. He's been a factor in the series with five RBIs on three hits. Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. Lynn's ready. 0-1 pitch on its way. No plate discipline that time, and he's in the hole now. 0-2.
With the way this guy's throwing on the mound, you cannot be chasing. You have to set your sights a little bit lower and control the strike zone.
And he missed with it. It's 1-2. Bases are empty here with two men out. Started to go around, but it's a called third strike anyway, and that will retire the side. So the Yanks go 1-2-3. We played two full innings, and we are tied 1-1. So next to the plate for Texas, Ronald Guzman.
The first baseman, Ronald Guzman.
Here comes the first pitch. And that's in there for a strike. A bouncer to the left side. Andujar fields it cleanly. And oh, the throw pulls the first baseman off the bag, and he'll reach it first. So you can mark that one down as an E5, and I bet he'd like to have that one over. Back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring up the shortstop, Elvis Andrus.
Goes to show you how strong this guy is. That wasn't a bad breaking ball that he hit for a home run in that last at bat. That ball was down and away. He went out and hooked it and pulled it. This guy's definitely a good hitter.
High fly ball out to straightaway center, and Gardner there to put it away for the first down.
Next to the Rangers, the right fielder, Hunter Cole.
Now batting, Hunter Cole. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yeah, and he didn't put up much of a fight either, Matty. Gotta find a way. Can't go down three pitches. I don't care if you're staring at him or swinging at him. You have to find a way to make this pitcher work a little bit harder.
No balls and a strike to count. Runner on first here with one gone and a 1-1 tie. Takes a pitch high and away for ball one.
1-1.
Hits this one hard the other way. And that's through for a base hit. Make him 1-for-2 in this one.
Boy, that's one of the, I guess, the advantages of hitting with that hole between first and second base, D-Row. First baseman has to hold that runner on. That leaves that right side wide open.
Yeah, and credit the batter right there. Nice piece of hitting right there. Not trying to do too much. He took a look at the defense and saw where it was aligned and tried to beat him.
At the plate now, Willie Calhoun. As he'll look at a changeup that drops below the knees for ball one. Runners are at first and second with one away. And a fastball runs a bit inside. He's down 2-0.
Hey, time to start making some quality pitches. He finds himself in a tough spot behind an account with guys on base.
The 2-0 pitch finds the zone, strike one.
That's evidence of a pitcher and catcher being totally in sync out there. That tells me they both know that's a good pitch for him right now.
He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. Here's a big swing and a miss on the fastball, 2-2. First and second now, one man out. And this is swung on and missed. His fifth strikeout already, and there are two gone in the inning.
Well, his struggles continue. It's been a rough roll of it at the plate with him, and watching this at bat, it's clear to me that his rhythm and timing, they're just all off. Even as a pitcher like I was, you can tell these things and exploit them.
Here's Joey Gallo now. And so weighed out a breaking pitch here that finds the zone for strike one. First time up, he went down looking. He's set. The 0-1. Oh, and you talk about a pitcher getting the benefit of the doubt. That's low, but called a strike anyway. Nothing in two now.
Well, you can see he's coming right at this guy, just pounding the ball in the strike zone. He certainly has the advantage now. This guy hasn't even swung the bat yet.
And he misses there, 1-2.
Well, tried to throw a high fastball right by him there. Didn't work, but now we'll see if that sets up some different options. Wouldn't be surprised to see a good slider down and away right here.
Counts even 2-2 to Joey Gallo.
This is a huge pitch right here. I don't think he wants to go 3-2 and have those runners be in motion. Look for him to be aggressive with what he thinks is his best pitch right now.
Oh, a fastball swung on and missed, and for the second time today, he's gone on strikes. Back-to-back strikeouts keep him out of danger. We're back with more on a Sunday afternoon following this. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and that'll bring up Gary Sanchez.
The catcher, Gary Sanchez.
First offering on its way. Pitch on the way. Now a cut fastball, but that doesn't threaten the zone. It's even at one. And that misses, 2-1. Line to the right side. And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit. With that, the Yankees have put their leadoff hitter aboard to start out the inning.
He just sports that ball up the wall, and now the question will be, should he have continued on or not? He thought about pushing it, I'm sure, but decided to play it safe. It would have been close, but I think this time he's probably right in staying at first.
So here's the veteran Brett Gardner. Hit high and deep out there to left center field. And that ball gets down out near the wall and should be extra bases. And they've really got something going here. Runners at second and third to start the inning.
Everyone knows that this guy's numbers are not where he wants them to be so far this year. But you never know by that swing. He looked fluid and confident driving that pitch for a double. We'll see if that gets him going a bit.
In now, Gio Urshela. Pitch is popped up. Frazier is there. And he hauls it in for the first out of the inning.
Great scoring opportunity miss right there. You talk about frustration. Popping it up with two runners in scoring position. He'd like to get that one back.
Here's Miguel Andujar now. And he's off to a hot start in this one. Homered his first time around.
Yeah, man, this guy flexed his muscles in that last at bat. We heard that he has good power. That last bomb had to go well over 400 feet. He hit it a long way.
And that fastball's taken, but catches the outer third. Runners are at second and third with one down. And it's one and one. Fouled off. Fouled away. The 1-2. Fastball, but that's easy to lay off, and it's back to even at 2-2.
I don't blame the pitcher one bit for trying to get to Chase right there. He's been fouling everything off. He's still got the entire arsenal open to him, so we'll see what pitch he comes with next.
2-2 pitch is fouled away.
Four foul balls in this AB. Pitcher cannot find anywhere to go to put this guy away.
Swing and a little blooper to center. In there, base hit.
Hey, they weren't going to keep this guy down for long. That's the ebbs and flows of a baseball season. Bottom line is, this guy has bat to ball skills. You knew he was going to get hot eventually.
And that sends DJ LeMahieu into the box. He swings and sends a bullet to right field. And that's in there, base hit. One run scores. The runner from second crosses the plate. It's now 3-1.
Hey, this one's a long way from being over, D-Roll, but that big base hit right there gives him a two-run lead.
Yeah, Dan, without question right there. Huge at bat. Gives his team the lead. Hopefully the pitcher's able to settle down now. He's got some runs on his back, and he's able to go out and execute.
And that'll bring up Aaron Judge, as he'll take a first pitch curveball right down the middle for strike one.
Well, I think he's got to find a way out of this jam and limit the damage. If he's unable to do that, this game could get away from him.
Runners are at first and third, one away. Here's one that misses high. It's 1-1.
This inning hasn't gone the way he wanted it to, but it's not a total disaster yet. Sometimes pitching is about damage control, so if he can strand these guys out there, that would be pretty huge.
1-1. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Gallo has it, and I'd be surprised if they send the runner. And he'll think better of trying to score as he holds it third with two away now.
The designated hitter, Wainwright Torres.
And that'll bring up Gleyber Torres. He was a strikeout victim in his first try.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
Lynn comes set. First pitch on its way. Outside with the fastball, that's 1-0. Runners on first and third, two away. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0. Two and one the count. Hoping to limit the damage, here's the pitch. And he fouls this one off. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Three balls and two strikes to the Yankees DH.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
He's set, and the payoff pitch, and it's fouled away. Keeps fighting him off. The eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. High and deep down the left field line, and no one will get this one. Hit sharply toward the right side. Cole is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. So it's two runs on four base hits, no errors, and a couple of men left on. On now to the top of inning number four. The Yankees lead it 3-1. Welcome back to the Bronx as we check in with Heidi.
Matt, I talked with the Rangers manager during the inning break about the team's offensive production to this point.
And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats.
Yes, they've only scored one run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up, and he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this game goes on.
All right, Heidi, thank you. In now, Robinson Chirinos, a base hit in his first trip.
Hey, we're still in the early stages in this one. They're only down by a couple of runs, but it's really key for this leadoff guy to try to get on and get a big inning started.
First pitch on its way. The windup and the 0-1. Just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call.
Pitcher wants to have a quick inning right here, capitalize on the momentum his batters have.
A 1-1. It is a fastball, then off the plate for a ball. Now the 2-1 pitch. It's a high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone. Nearly a big fly to start the inning. Instead, a foul ball. And they really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out.
I'll tell you, it's hard to get more of a confidence boost than striking out the best hitters in the lineup. Back to back to back, he's looking really sharp right now.
Into the box now, Danny Santana. As he'll take a look at an off-speed pitch here that misses for ball one. Comes into this at-bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. Fouled off. And he looks at one in there, 1-2.
Hey, he's got great feel for that pitch right there. He can throw it anytime he wants for a strike.
Changed up on him as this is grounded to second. LeMahieu's got it. Throw on to first, two gone. So with two gone here in the fourth, let's check out our pitch speed comparison for the two starters. And whoa, look at that for a top speed. 98 miles an hour. That man is flat dealing. So bases are empty here with two gone, and standing in a power threat in Todd Frazier, the third baseman. First offering on its way. Starts things here with a changeup for a called strike. Here comes the 0-1. And there's ball one.
Hey, a two-out walk right here would be the tying run to the plate. Even though it's early on, you got a guy on deck that has a lot of pop.
Fouled away. Three to one is our score here in inning number four. Tough pitch to lay off there, but he did, and it's even up at 2-2.
He might have to look for a different way to put this guy away on 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times, so he might be looking for it.
And he lays off a pitch off the plate and high, 3-2. Hit to short. That's through for a base hit, and he's one for two now.
Dan, I'll tell you, it doesn't matter what it looks like right there. That long dart felt so good.
Oh, Dilo, this guy's been due. He really needed that one.
Here's Rougned Odor now. As he'll take a look at a high strike here on the outside corner, it's 0-1. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. Tying run at the plate, the 0-1. Right there, and it's quickly 0-2 now.
He's looking pretty passive here, hitting with a chance to drive in a run. Gonna have to make something happen with two strikes now.
0-2, here it comes. Line hard toward right center. In there, a base hit.
Hey, after back-to-back two-out hits right now, this pitcher thought he was going to cruise through this inning, and now he's got traffic, and he's in jeopardy with a ball in the gap or a ball missed over the harder plate, a crooked number going on the board.
Standing in now, Ronald Guzman. And he'll promptly send it in the air out to center field. Urshela has a play, and that retires the side. Rangers leave a pair, and it remains a 3-1 ball game. Just about set to go for the last of the fourth, but before we do that, here's Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with the Yankees manager Aaron Boone during the break about the team's offensive performance so far. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. They've been able to push across three runs to this point, but they've also made the opposition work extremely hard. He's thrown a lot of pitches, and they think they're going to have a good opportunity to push across a lot more runs as he tires or as they get into that bullpen.
Okay, thank you, Heidi.
leading off for the Yankees.
Next for New York, Giancarlo Stanton. He's set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning.
One of the keys to securing a win, they want to keep the pressure on and try to build that lead as much as they can moving into the later innings.
No balls and one strike. A little quick on that swing, and he finds himself behind 0-2. And he fouls this one off. Set to deliver on nothing and two. Here it comes.
Count of 1-2.
Now a swing and a miss, and Stanton is down on strikes for out number one.
Boy, there's nothing like seeing a good power pitcher that has a good fastball. And what does he do? He just throws this good fastball right by, brings the express. No chance to put that ball in play.
At the plate, Luke Voit. As he grounds one briskly to short, there is Andrus. Throw in time at first for out number two.
Now batting, catcher Gary Sanchez.
So two are gone now in the Yankee half of the fourth, and the next to bat, the Dominican-born catcher Gary Sanchez. Here comes the first pitch.
Nope.
Ball one. Hits are even right now at five aside. Fastball just missed above the zone. There's a swing, and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. Gallo has to retreat to the track, but he has it to retire the side. 1-2-3 go the Bombers, but they hang on to a 3-1 lead. Elvis Andrus the next to bat. He'll get his side started in the inning, and Dan, so far they've been stifled offensively since the first inning.
Boy, they sure have, Matt. They came out of the gates and got hot right away, but whatever was going for them pretty much has disappeared. We'll see if they can wake it back up.
Here it comes now to Andrus.
It's much easier to lay off the breaking stuff when it's coming in towards you instead of when it breaks away. A good take there.
Now the 1-0. Hit hard on the ground towards second. Gloved by LeMahieu. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away.
Now batting.
Good range shown off into the hole right there. That's not an easy play, but these guys make it look that way sometimes.
Stepping up now, Hunter Cole. He singled his last time up.
Yeah, guys, everyone knows he's been slumping. Dan, you can certainly attest to this, only amassing a solid one hit in your entire career. But pressure's off now. Maybe he gets hot.
And that swung on and missed for strike one. Double-barreled action in the Yankee bullpen now. A lefty and a right-hander start to get loose. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Right side, but it's going to be a foul ball. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Misses ball two. Full count now, 3-2.
That was kind of a gift to the hitter. He's up there probably thinking of protecting on 2-2, but when you launch a ball that high out of the strike zone,
he's able to take the ball the other way here. High and deep to right center.
Gone!
Go! Solo shot to right center. 7 home runs for him on the year now. And the Rangers have come back to cut this to a 3-2 ball game now.
There's an old saying in the game. They say solo homers won't kill you. This might be a good time for a mound visit right here. Try and erase those negative thoughts and get right back in the zone. You still have the lead.
Here comes the Yankee skipper on his way to the mound, and it would appear he's seen enough of his starter this afternoon. So he'll head to the dugout after working just 4 1/3, not enough to qualify for the victory, as his bullpen will have to go a long way to hang on to the lead. Jay Happ, a 6'5" left-hander, takes over on the mound now.
Number 33, Jay Happ.
To the plate now, Willie Calhoun, as he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. He's hitless in his 2 at-bats so far. The 1-0. It's laid off, but in there for strike one. Off for a ball, 2-1.
A couple strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at bat trying to get ahead and put himself in a good hitter's count.
Line toward right center. Gardner will range to his left and put it away. 2 down.
He got that one pretty good. It just didn't have the right launch angle to carry over the outfielder's head. Small difference where the ball hit the bat could have made all the difference.
Up next for the Rangers, Joey Gallo, 0-2 on his line thus far. Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. And, oh, looked inside, but that's ruled a strike. Nothing in one.
Hey, they say solos won't kill us, but I got to believe this guy's looking to do exactly that.
Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball. Two runs, 6 hits, and no errors in the contest for the Rangers so far. 1-1 pitch is a slider that's cut on and missed for strike two. To 2 balls and 2 strikes now. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Yanked the slider across that time. Laid off for a ball. Robinson Chirinos would be next. And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one. Rangers draw just a bit closer thanks to this solo home run. Bottom of the fifth coming up. It's the Yankees 3 and the Rangers 2. Set now for the bottom of the fifth. And up next, the left-handed hitting Brett Gardner.
The center fielder, Brett Gardner.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch.
That's the ball. Count 1-0.
The 1-1. This one to right field and deep off the bat of Gardner. Right fielder looking up, and this one is gone. A home run. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. Eighth home run on the season for him, and it'll give the Yankees a 4-2 lead.
I know hindsight's 20-20, but you can't throw that pitch to that guy. Don't forget, he homered yesterday, so you know he's locked in and ready to roll up there. We'll see if he learns from that mistake.
At the plate now, Gio Urshela.
Number 29.
As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one.
It might be time for this guy to start mixing his pitches up a little bit better. He's pitching poorly, but you look at his first pitch strike percentage at over 70%. This team batting has a pretty good idea what his game plan is.
Guzman is over, and he's got it for the first out of the inning.
The batter, the third baseman, Miguel Andujar.
Digging in now, Miguel Andujar. One run in and one gone so far this inning. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Curveball, and that misses in the dirt for ball one. Both teams with six hits so far. A swing and a ground ball to third. On it goes right through him into left field.
Well, I think it's safe to say the ice has melted on this guy. He had been cold coming into this game, but that being his third knock, I guarantee you my man's smiling on the inside.
In now, DJ LeMahieu, as he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. Here's one that misses high. It's 1-1. And now the Ranger bullpen swings into action. A lefty and a right-hander are throwing down there. Runners on first with one down. He's running. And he connects with it. This one's hit deep out to left center field. And this ball is gone. No chance to make a play on that one. So a two-run shot to left center, home run number 5 on the year, as they open it up to 6-2 now.
Another excellent swing right there. That's multiple home runs in the same inning. Watch yourself. You're missing over the heart of the plate.
Colby Allard, 6'1" southpaw, will be the one that gets the call from the bullpen here.
Colby Allard.
Here's big Aaron Judge as he lays off a fastball too low for ball one. Allard, once an Atlanta Brave, he was acquired via trade last year.
Yeah, this guy's fully settled in with this ball club right now. Knows what the manager and coaching staff expect from him. Is not taken aback by anything. He's been through the spring training process and gotten to know everybody in this organization top to bottom.
Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. Allard has registered just under 110 innings on the mound and logged in with an ERA in the low threes. 1-1 is swung on and missed, and that's strike two. Way out in front as this is yanked foul into the seats in left. Three runs already home here. And a fastball blew it right by him, and there are two down. So bases are empty here with two gone, and that'll bring up the exciting middle infielder, Gleyber Torres.
Gleyber Torres.
Here's the first pitch to him.
Hey! 0-1's the count.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. And he lays off for ball one.
That's a good pitch to lay off right there, that cutter inside. And that is a real tough pitch for hitters to lay off of. And a lot of times, if you do swing at that cutter in, you're going to end up with some firewood and a broken bat.
From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1.
One strike.
Three and one.
Good job to work the count and put himself back in the driver's seat. Started off with one strike, and now he's got the count in his favor, 3-1.
3-2, full count. Now the payoff pitch home. High in the air out to center field. Santana will get there and he puts it away to retire the side. So two home runs in the inning lead to three runs on the scoreboard. We're through five here at the ballpark. The Yankees lead it 6-2. So stepping in, Robinson Chirinos, 1-for-2. He singled and struck out in two trips.
This one doesn't look good so far. Down by a boatload as we enter the middle innings. It's about time they get something going, and the last thing you want to do is fall behind where you have to score a bunch in the eighth and ninth inning.
1-0 the count. That missed close. It's ball two.
Hey, you want to talk about being in a zone? This guy's been raking lately, and it all starts with his pitch selection. Two great takes, and he's almost daring the pitcher just go ahead and challenge him.
Swing and a miss on the heater, and it's 2-1. Inside for a ball as he falls behind to him here, 3-1.
Well, that's ball three, and right now the Rangers would do anything to get that leadoff guy on.
Tough pitch to lay off, but he did, and it's ball four, so the leadoff hitter is aboard to start the sixth.
And that's what you want from your leadoff hitter. Show some great patience and discipline, making the pitcher labor to start the game. The result is a leadoff walk and a chance to make some early noise.
Digging in the switch hitter, Danny Santana. He's 0-for-2 thus far in this one. He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch.
All you want is the leadoff man to get on to start a big inning, maybe get a big rally going to claw your way back into this ball game.
Two runs, six hits, and no errors in the contest for the Rangers so far. Got him to swing at a pitch below the knees, 1-1.
Good thing he didn't make contact with that pitch. Only thing he could do is probably hit that on the ground. It could be a double play ball.
The 1-1.
Ball, that's out.
Sometimes you got to be aggressive offensively, but sometimes you just let the pitcher dig his own grave. Patience and discipline seem to be the way to go right here.
Not an easy pitch to lay off of, but he did somehow, and he's got it to 3-1.
Got to find a way to get back in his zone. I know you're in danger of losing both to walks, but certainly don't miss over the heart of the plate and have this guy gap one, or even worse, hit a two-run homer.
And he lays off there, ball four. So back-to-back walks have him in business here with nobody out.
Now batting, the third baseman, Todd.
Standing in, Todd Frazier popped out and singled in his two trips to the plate. First delivery to him on the way.
Ball, that's out.
Here it comes, 1-0. And he takes a cold strike one. Grounded down the third baseline. And that's a fair ball as this one gets by him at third. And the runner from second is in to score. It's now a 6-3 contest.
Now back. Second baseman. O'Doul.
So here's the left-handed bat of Rougned Odor. He swings and hits it foul off to the right and out of play. A hit and two tries for him so far. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Gardner is right there, one down. And he'll move up to third now. Runners at the corners here with one away.
Good read there at second base to know he could make it to third on the flyout. Now he's only 90 feet away with one out.
Stepping up to the plate, Ronald Guzman. And he's got runners at the corners here with only one gone. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch.
Everyone in the ballpark knows what the pitcher's intentions are in this situation. Great job at the plate to lay off a tough pitch in a good spot.
He's ready. Here's the 1-0. 2-0.
He's already walked two in this inning already. This guy just can't seem to find the strike zone.
The 2-0. A line shot to third base.
Now batting. Shortstop. Elder. Andrew.
Big spot here. Runners at the corners. Two gone. And it's back to the top of the lineup now for Elvis Andrus. Looking to minimize the damage here. Runners at the corners, two men out. Hit hard on the ground to the right. And a backhanded reach at first, but he can't flag it down. The runner from third comes across to score as they try and chip away at their deficit. Now a 6-4 ball game.
Hunter Cole.
Into the box now, Hunter Cole, as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike. So far, 2-for-3 in this one. Swung on and missed that strike two.
Hey, down in the count 0-2, I'd like to see a little choke and poke right here. Maybe work it up the middle or opposite field with two strikes.
Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. So it's two runs on two hits, no errors, and two men left stranded. Sixth, seventh, and eighth place hitters due up in the bottom of inning number six. It's the Yankees 6 and the Rangers 4. At the plate, Giancarlo Stanton, 0-for-2 for him to this point.
Giancarlo Stanton.
First offering on its way. Strike taken. Good pitch on the lower part of the zone.
It's pretty tough for a hitter to go up there looking for a first pitch changeup. And a good job of dropping it in for strike one.
Into the corner and slicing foul. Oh and two, here it comes. And he wastes a fastball high there, 1-2.
Love the high heater right there to raise the hitter's sights. Let's see if he buries something in the dirt right here.
Now a swing and a miss, and Stanton is down on strikes for out number one. So they do pick up the out here, but with six runs home against them already, it's not going to help out the team ERA by any stretch of the imagination. And as you can see there, they find themselves hovering just a few spaces above the bottom in the entire American League. Stepping in, Luke Voit. Third trip to the plate for him here. He struck out and grounded out in his first two tries. And now a pitch on the way. The cutter runs outside, ball one. The 1-0 is laid off for ball two. That'll find its way out of play. Still going to have a good hitter's count. 2-1 now. Both teams with eight hits in this one. Donnie extends nicely, and this ball's driven to right field and deep. And that'll get down out there for extra bases. And he'll reach second now with one away.
That was a great job of driving that ball, extending his arms very well, was able to get it over the right fielder's head, one hopping it off the wall for an easy double. That's one of those solid hits that you don't even feel coming off the bat.
So now to the plate, Gary Sanchez, as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. Runner at second here with one man out. And he falls behind 0-2. And another foul ball. Pulls this one in the air out to left. Gallo will drift over to his right a few steps as he takes it for the second out.
The center fielder, number 11, Brett Gardner.
Here's Brett Gardner now. He's coming off a solo homer in his previous trip.
And hey, it was a breaking ball to boot. This guy's a pretty good off-speed hitter. You could tell by that last at-bat, he wasn't fooled at all. He sat back, waited, got the breaking ball, and didn't miss it.
Ball one to start the at-bat. And he gets a piece of it here, but it's chopped foul. One and two now. And a fastball swung on and missed, and the side is retired. The Yanks leave one. They're up 6-4. Zach Britton is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven.
Number 53, Zach Britton.
Seventh inning ready to roll, and striding forward, the designated hitter, Willie Calhoun.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a bloop and a blast? They could certainly use that right now.
First pitch of the at bat. Oh, that's out. A ball and no strikes. Here it is.
That's a ball.
Well, this is the matchup they wanted, bringing in the reliever, but falling behind 2-0 doesn't exactly help the situation very much.
And now a pitch on the way. Not very aggressive there, as that's down the middle for strike one.
Tying run stands on deck, but it'll only matter if the guy in the box can get on base.
Yeah, and that has to be his mentality at the plate right now, Matt. He can't be the hero, so he needs to do what he can to give the guy behind him a chance to be the guy.
And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball.
It's a fine line from working down in the zone on 2-2 and bouncing one in there that basically stands no chance of getting swung at. Right there, he basically spiked that one right into the dirt, and now he has to find the zone on a 3-2 pitch.
Swung on in the dirt for the third strike. And the throw is there to record the first out. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Joey Gallo. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, Matty, big time K last time up, and it's been a tough series for him so far. You can tell he's just not seeing the ball off this team. Let's see if he can make an adjustment right here.
Bases are empty, one man out. Now a swing, and he just fouls this one away. The 1-1 home.
Ball. Two balls, one strike.
And he'll strike out here yet again, as it's been a ball game to forget thus far. Four strikeouts.
Wow, he's just a lost cause in this one. That's the fourth time he struck out in this game alone, and that's not something you'll forget very quickly. That's about as bad of a day as you can have.
Standing in now, Robinson Chirinos, as he'll take a look at a slider here that misses for ball one. A hit and two at bats for him at this point in the ballgame. Inside, and he falls behind the hitter now, 2-0. Swung on and hit deep to left center. This one has a chance. And that is off the wall. And now he'll get into scoring position with two away.
Any hitter will tell you that a shot like that just feels different. It sounds different off the bat. See his arms get extended, right arm tucked up against his body, barrel the bat all over the ball, and he smokes it right off the wall at left center. A little more hang time, and that one probably gets out of here.
Stepping in now, Danny Santana, as he lines it out to center. That's in there, base hit. Chirinos rounds the corner and is headed home. He'll score easily, and things have gotten interesting at this point. It's now a 6-5 game.
Well, he was almost out of the inning. Then the last two batters showed him that you can't lose focus on the mound, even if you get two quick outs. Back-to-back doubles shows you just how quickly things can get away from you.
Chad Green will get the ball here as he looks to get the final out in the top of the seventh.
Number 57, Chad Green.
At the plate now, Todd Frazier, as he'll take a look at a high strike that time. It's nothing and one. He's 2-for-3 and looking for more here. ready with the 0-1. Hit out towards second. And a diving effort there, but it'll come up empty. It's a base hit. But it's offline. He scores. And this ball game is tied here in the seventh. The tag, and they'll get him at second. And with that, the side is retired. So two runs on three hits, no errors, and no one left on base. On now to the bottom of inning number seven. And we are all even at six apiece. Cody Allen gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh. So back to the top of the Yankee order, digging in, Gio Urshela. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. First offering on its way. Had him reaching that time. It's strike one.
You have to find a way to lay off that low sinker. There is just no way to do any damage. You're just looking at either a bruised shin or a ground out to the left side.
Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Gallo has him played perfectly as he puts it away for out number one.
Now batting, third baseman, Miguel Andujar.
One gone here in the Yankee seventh, and striding into the plate, it'll be Miguel Andujar. First pitch coming, here it is. And he takes ball one. The 1-0 home.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
One out, nobody on. And he lays off ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here.
Now batter, the second baseman, TJ.
So a runner at first now with one away, and that'll bring in DJ LeMahieu.
The last at bat, Matty D, we heard this guy's a good fastball hitter. He got a fastball and didn't miss it. We'll see if they pitch him a little bit differently this time and mix in some off-speed pitches.
One ball, no strikes to count. And he just misses inside with the fastball there.
Clearly working the bottom of the zone, trying to get a ground ball for a double play.
Two well count, the pitch. Possible go-ahead runs on first, one away. Runners on the move for second, and it's fouled away. Here now the 2-2. He is swung on and missed, he got him.
That was a big strikeout there, guys. The best pitchers have the ability to strike guys out when they really need to. And that second out was really important at this point of the game. Could be something we look back on later when the game's over.
At the plate, Aaron Judge, as he looks at a fastball that misses off the plate for ball one. We could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far. The 1-0 delivery. Hit on the ground out to short. Little pitch and catch chance for Odor at second base, and that'll do it. One left for the Yankees. Weir still tied 6-6. Ready to begin the eighth, and set to go is the second baseman, Rougned Odor.
Rougned Odor.
First offering on its way.
Yeah.
And some action out in the Yankee bullpen now as a right-hander starts to loosen up. On its way, the 0-1 pitch.
Good pitch right there with the bases empty. Why not take a shot? Throw that breaking ball in the dirt and see if he'll chase after it.
Ready to deliver the 1-2.
That's Bolton.
The classic back foot slider right there with two strikes. Usually gets a ton of swing and misses. Nice layoff right there. Fight for another pitch.
And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2.
Wow, from 0-2 to 3-2, and that last pitch on 2-2 wasn't even close. He had this guy in the ropes, but now he let him right back into this at bat.
And the payoff pitch. As anticipated, here's a ground ball now to the right side. LeMahieu's got it, and a great athletic play to get him. Man, wow.
Now batting, the first baseman, Ronald.
So one gone now in the Texas half of the eighth, and that'll bring up the left-handed hitting Ronald Guzman. From the stretch. Off the plate and low here, ball one. Here it comes, 1-0. Swing and a miss, and it's a ball and two strikes here.
Beautifully thrown splitter right there. High 80s down in the zone. Looks like a fastball coming, and then boom, the bottom falls out of it. Terrific pitch.
The 1-2 pitch. Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone. Time now for our starter comparison, and that tells the story. As you can see, neither guy able to get past five innings. So the Rangers batting order turns over and set to go. Elvis Andrews, he went deep earlier and he's 2-for-4 to this point. First delivery to him on the way.
Nope, outside.
This year against right-handed pitching, Andrews hits a little over the 270 mark. Here's the 1-0. That one catches the edge of the zone, called a strike. Two out, nobody on. Two balls and a strike to the Rangers leadoff hitter. Two and one, here it is.
One of the best ways to keep a guy uncomfortable is to pound him inside. They're doing that, and this one caught the zone.
He stays alive, still 2-2.
down the left field line and deep. And this will wind up a foul ball. And a half-hearted swing there as they tie him up inside for the third strike, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Rangers. Score remains tied, 6 apiece. Brett Martin is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 59, Brett Martin.
Bottom of inning number 8 set to go, and that'll bring up Gleyber Torres.
The designated hitter, Gleyber.
Here comes the first pitch. A little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Heading out towards shallow right. And this is going to get down for what should be extra bases. And there's your potential go-ahead run. And your go-ahead run is in at second base here with a leadoff double.
Wow, he must be living right because he gets absolutely jammed. Thought we were going to see the bat splintered, but instead he muscles the ball to right for a double. Might get some heckles from his teammates, but no doubt he'll take it.
And time will be called here, as with the important go-ahead run at second base, they'll opt to go and get a little more speed out there. Giancarlo Stanton now. It's been a rough go of things at the plate for him so far, but his guys are looking for him to change that right here.
Yeah, nothing better than coming through for the boys in a tight game, Matt, especially when you're kind of due to do something productive.
First pitch of the at bat, and a slider tails outside for ball one. The 1-0, a swing and a miss. That's the first strike.
This is going to be an interesting at bat. I think he has to be pitching for a strikeout here, so we'll see what kind of sequence he uses.
The 1-1 and strike two swinging. The 1-2 is taken for ball two. He struck him out, the third time he's fanned in the game. Striding into the box, Luke Voit. It was a two-bagger for him in his last at bat.
Well, he got a good pitch to hit last time up. Looked for it up in the zone and didn't miss it. Those are the pitches you only get maybe once an AB, maybe once a game, maybe once a week. So he certainly capitalized on it last time.
From the stretch, here's the pitch. In the dirt here, and a nice job keeping it close. It's ball one. The 1-0 home. Runners on his way to third. pitch outside. The throw. And an offline throw, but he gets the tag down, and he is out at third. Hitters count. Here it comes. Swung on, but it's pulled foul wide of third. And here's the 3-2. Liner in there for a base hit.
No mistake what he was sitting on. Fastball middle of the plate, kept his hands back, stayed through the baseball, and delivers a hard hit line drive.
To the plate now, Gary Sanchez. As he'll take a look at a slider here that finds the zone for strike one. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Comes set, the 0-1. Here's a fastball that crowds him a bit, and it's 1-1. One and one. Here it is. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
A great case of a manager sticking up for his pitcher right there and giving that umpire an earful. He didn't get that pitch called the way he wanted it to, but the manager's planting a seed in that umpire's mind to try to expand the strike zone so some of those borderline pitches start to go his pitcher's way.
And he misses with it, ball four. So the potential go-ahead run moves into scoring position now.
He did not want to let the hitter off the hook with two outs, and now he's got a runner in scoring position to deal with.
Mike Tauchman will come on to pinch hit here in a big spot.
Hitting for the Yankees, number 39, Mike Tauchman.
Fastball too high to start him out here, 1-0. Both teams right now with 11 hits in the ballgame. Lifted down the line in left. Frazier trying to get there, and this will wind up a foul ball. Ready with the 1-1. Slider bends into the middle of the strike zone, taken for a strike.
Might have been taking all the way right there. That pitch couldn't have split the strike zone any better. And you can bet he wants that one back at the plate.
In the dirt, but swung on and missed. Chirinos recovers. And the throw to first ends the inning. Yanks strand a pair. This game remains tied at 6. Mike Tauchman will stay in the ballgame as he takes over in center.
Now playing center field, number 39.
Standing in, Hunter Cole. He'll lead things off against the same reliever that finished off the last inning.
Well, you don't see in this day too many relievers going multiple innings, but guys have to earn that trust from their managers. We'll see how he handles it here.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. A one pitch on its way.
A ball that close.
Pitch down that swung on and sent to second base. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway.
Not a lot you can do with that pitch. That fastball just ate him up inside and gets the soft grounder for the out.
To the plate now for Texas is the DH, Willie Calhoun. He was sat down on strikes in his last at bat. He's set. Here it comes.
Oh, that's
right. He's ready. Here's the 1-0. And this winds up inside for a ball. 2-0 now. Good comeback fastball there. It's two balls and a strike.
He knows full well he's sitting on a hat trick right here. All he's trying to do is avoid the golden sombrero.
Three balls and a strike to Willie Calhoun.
I can't tell you how big a pitch the last one was. The difference between 3-1 and 2-2. 2-2, you're probably taking a turn for the dugout.
Lays off ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here.
Now batting left fielder.
Now time is called and we'll have a pinch runner at first, and that'll be a wise decision as he's the potential go-ahead run. Next to bat will be the Texas cleanup hitter Joey Gallo. There's one away. The runner at first represents the potential go-ahead score. Double play is in order, however. Here's the first pitch.
Count 1-0.
Possible go-ahead runs on first, one away. That one will get out of play, and the count evens up at 1-1. The 1-1 pitch. And it's 1-2.
Yep, 1-2.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention please. Now running the first for the Rangers. Number 16.
Now the 1-2 pitch. And he strikes out again. And that's the fifth time he's punched out today. This has certainly not been his game.
Runner on first in a double play situation. So you expect to see a lot of pitches down in the zone. So I think that pitch up right there was a good one. Obviously, the double play is more efficient, but you're always going to take a K when you're on the mound.
Jonathan Holder has been summoned here and will try to keep this one tied heading to the bottom of the ninth. Into the box, Robinson Chirinos. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. Holder is at least partially known for a good changeup, and it's not just any change of speed pitch. It dances all over the place. Swing and a liner. That's in for a base hit. He's now 3-for-4.
Yeah, that hard hit single right there, that's clean. 3-for-4, he's looking locked in.
Standing in now, Danny Santana. As the first pitch to him is taken low and away for ball one. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. And this is a fastball that's right on the black but ruled a ball. It's 2-0 now.
Got to find a way to execute either a good fastball down and away or flip something off speed for a strike. You cannot miss over the heart of the plate in these situations. The hitter is on high alert.
And that one's wide of the mark. Ball three.
Well, two on, two outs, and he's got himself in a great hitter's count. He just has to be careful not to get too aggressive. A walk would be good here, too.
The 3-0, and that misses for ball four. So the potential go-ahead run moves over to third now.
Man, when you don't get a call on a pitch that good, you have to wonder if maybe it's personal. You can't blame him for being angry, but he's got to find a way to move on and focus on the next batter.
So a big spot here, and stepping in, Todd Frazier, as he'll hit with the go-ahead run at third and two away. Here's the first pitch. A ball and no strikes. Hot shot down the line, but a foul ball, 1-1. One and one. Here it is.
It often becomes harder to hit the zone when the pressure starts to heat up.
Two and one. Here it is. Popped him up. Voit has room in foul territory. He's got it, and that'll get him out of the jam. Rangers threaten, but leave them loaded. Weir still tied 6-6. Jose Leclerc comes on to work on the mound, hoping to send this one into extra innings.
Okay, Leclerc.
Back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, Gio Urshela, 0-for-4 with a strikeout thus far.
Number 29.
Here comes the first pitch. Just off the outside, and it's 1-0. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Who pulled the string and had him way out in front, a ball and a strike. Leclerc has tossed over 30 innings so far this season, and through those innings he's posted a whip a little under 1.5. Certainly something he'd like to improve on. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Hopped up. Guzman in foul ground. One away.
Now batting. Third baseman, Miguel Andujar.
Stepping into the box, Miguel Andujar. It was a walk in his last trip. He's set, and the pitch.
Count 1-0.
Seeing him just a little too amped up out there right now. That's common with hard throwers like him. Running a blazing fastball up there is great, but if you can't harness it, what good does it do you?
Hit on the ground to third. And there's out number two.
The batter, the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu.
Striding in once again, DJ LeMahieu. Two hits in four attempts to this point. First pitch of the at bat.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
Here's the 1-0.
Two balls, no strike.
Non-competitive pitch right there. Runs the count to 2-0, and he is ready to do some damage in the box.
The 2-0. And a good eye that time to lay off the fastball. It's 3-0.
If you're at the plate right now, you have to realize who's on deck. I guarantee you something's over the heart of the plate. You have to be aggressive in the zone right here.
Swing here on the fastball, and this will get fouled off to the right side. Bases are empty here with two men out. Scorch to third. Frazier is there. Throw on to Guzman at first, and the inning is over. So they can't get that winning run home, and that means free baseball here this afternoon. 10th inning coming up, and we are all even at 6 apiece. We are into extra innings, and standing in is the power hitting second baseman, Rougned Odor. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes.
Man, that's one of those. How could you not swing at that one? A good take there on that pitch.
The 1-0 home.
Nope, up there.
Two balls and a strike.
Boy, what a time to pull the string on him. On 2-0, there's no way anyone's thinking changeup. So if you can locate it, that's pretty much unhittable.
Unable to get the bat around in time, and the count evens at 2-2. Bottom dropped out on him, and that's a strikeout. Throw down to first, one away.
Well, you know you made a real nice pitch when you bounce it in the dirt and you still get the hitter to swing at it. That tells me that there's a lot of deception in that pitch right now.
Settling in now, Ronald Guzman. Struggling so far in this one and looking to erase his 0-for-4 ball game right here. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. And a ball, 1-0. Bases are empty, one man out. Big swing and a miss at the changeup, a ball and a strike. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone.
I know he buried that slider in right there, but that's a dangerous pitch. If he doesn't pop commit and bury that inside, it leaks out over the plate. He can get hurt with that pitch.
Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
Well, that call looked like it was a little in the pitcher's favor, but it wasn't outrageous. Hey, listen, calling balls and strikes is a really tough job, and even the best are going to miss some from time to time, especially when they're sort of borderline like that last one. Not sure the hitter would want to hear that, though.
Into the box now, Elvis Andrews, as he takes a fastball off the plate for a ball, 1-0. He's looking for his third hit of the ball game here. He extends nicely, and this ball's driven to right field and deep. And he's going to make the catch. And he paid a big price for it, too, as he crashes headlong into the wall. One more look at the final out. A teeth rattler if ever there was one. A chance to win it now as we head to the bottom of the 10th, still tied. Ready for the bottom of the 10th here. And digging in is the outfielder, Aaron Judge.
Aaron.
First pitch coming. Here it is.
Nope. That's inside.
Now the 2-0 home is swung on and missed, strike one. Three and one now.
Well, it's a pretty well-known fact that your batting average goes up as you get into more favorable hitters counts, and that's especially true when we're talking about this kind of hitter. Not a great spot to be in if you're the pitcher.
Slapped hard the opposite way, and he is going to have extra bases to start it out, and your winning run will be in scoring position. And he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two-base hit. And he needed extra innings to get it, but there's his first hit of the game, and that'll keep the hit streak alive and kicking.
And D-Ro, that's one of the beautiful things about the game of baseball, right? You go extra innings, that lineup turns over, and was able to get him one extra AB.
Yeah, and he'd be lying right now if he said he wasn't thinking about it. The boys hooked him up right there. Pitching staff extended the game a little bit. One more plate appearance, and he extends the hit streak.
And he's got a chance to bring in the winning run. The question is whether they'll even pitch to him. The 0-1. And they'll go off speed here as this pitch misses. It's 2-1. Just behind the fastball there. Two strikes now.
Ooh-wee. That was some smoke right there. High fire right on by.
A possible winning run on second. No one out. Fastball swung on and missed for the first out. Got him with a good high fastball there. Danny, we see a lot of that pitch in strikeout situations these days. What makes it so effective?
I think, Matt, what makes it such a tough pitch is you're changing eye levels. That fastball up looks so enticing to hit that you think you see that ball as a hitter. Do you think you can drive it? But it's really hard to get on top of that good, high, hard fastball.
Stepping in now, Giancarlo Stanton. A hat trick already to his credit in this one, so he's looking to avoid the dreaded golden sombrero here. Called strike 0-2.
What a nasty pitch right there. Batter thought it was going to hit him, and it ends up breaking into the zone for a strike.
Can't get him to chase. It's 1-2.
It's a great job to lay off on that nasty slider right there. It's the toughest pitch. It was my toughest pitch to lay off of. I was always sitting fastball middle away, and when that slider came out, boy, did it look like a heater for a long time.
Now the 1-2 pitch, and he'll strike out here yet again, as it's been a ballgame to forget thus far. Four strikeouts.
This has not been a weekend to remember for him. He's just been completely lost at the plate, flailing all over the place. Now that's his sixth strikeout of the series. They've really got him figured out.
At the plate now, Luke Voit, as he'll take one up in the zone, but indeed in the strike zone for the first strike. It's been a 2-for-4 effort for him so far in the ballgame. And it's quickly 0-2. Oh and two count, the pitch. And this one gets away. And he's going to make it up to third here as he advances on the wild pitch.
That can be a tough read as a runner on second to see if the ball has gotten away enough to move to third. You have to be sure you can make it. He was there, and now he's only 90 feet away.
Big spot here. Possible winning run at third. Two down. And he strikes him out to retire the side, so we'll play at least one more. One hit, one left. No winner yet. On to inning number 11 we go, and we are all even at six apiece. Adam Ottavino takes the mound to start the 11th inning.
Now pitching for the New York Yankees, number 0, Adam Ottavino.
11th inning set to get underway, and standing in the rookie outfielder, Hunter Cole.
Hunter Cole.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Here's a slider to start things out. Looked at for ball one. And he watches one miss outside. 2-0 now.
You know, sometimes it takes a pitcher a few pitches to get going, but those two pitches weren't even close. Ball's behind an account, 2-0. It's time to start getting locked in.
Back up the middle, and that'll get through into center. So there's your possible go-ahead run on base now to lead off the inning.
There's a hard hit ground ball. Pitcher not able to get a glove on it. Hard single up the middle.
Yeah, watch your lips right there, Dan. Sent it back right where it came from.
To the plate now, Scott Heinemann. As he'll take a look at ball one. Go ahead run at first, nobody out. The 1-0. Swung on and missed, 1-1.
That's exactly the pitch you don't want to be chasing in these situations. He's going to keep that ball down below the hollow of the knee, try and get you to ground into a double play. You have to set your sights at least belt high.
The 1-1 pitch. Lifted into the air to shallow center. In comes the center fielder. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first out.
Now back, left fielder, Jerry Yellow.
So a runner at first now with one away, and up to bat next, the left-handed light tower power of Joey Gallo. Here's the first pitch, and a good fastball there, but this just misses the zone for ball one. Before the delivery, a check on that go-ahead run at first, and he just manages to get his hand in. Possible go-ahead runs on first, one away. Good swing, just got to try and straighten that one out.
It's going to be back to some serious tee work if he can't put that pitch in play right in his wheelhouse.
The 1-1 pitch. Down on strikes again, and that's the sixth time he's punched out today. That is just miserable.
Now batter
into the box now, Robinson Chirinos. There are two gone and the possible go-ahead run at first. Here's the first pitch. Two out with the possible go-ahead run at first. And this one's too far inside, ball two.
Too low to a guy with this kind of pop, you better be awfully careful because he's going to be swinging out of his shoes.
The 2-0. And he grooves the fastball there. This is hit high and deep out to straightaway center field. Tuchman retreats to the track, and he'll put this one away. So a sigh of relief as the side is retired. So no runs on a hit here, no errors, one man left on. It's getting late. One run can win it as we move to the bottom of the 11th. And we are all even at six apiece. Luis Garcia takes over now to start the home 11th, and he's looking to get this one to the visiting 12th. Set now for the bottom of the 11th, and that'll bring up Gary Sanchez.
The catcher, Gary Sanchez.
First delivery to him on the way. Tried to check it, and it's 0-1. Hit on the ground down the first baseline, but this will be a foul ball as he's behind 0-2 now. And they really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out.
It's not that easy to make a good hitter look that bad, but that's what happens when you can bring that fastball and ride it in on the inner half of the plate right there. You can get some pretty ugly swings.
So now to the plate, Mike Tuchman. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. Tuchman playing up the middle in center field in this one, although he is most often considered a left fielder. Now the 1-0 is in there for strike one. Garcia, the former Angel, he became a member of this team after signing as a free agent earlier this season.
Yeah, he didn't have an opportunity to really get acclimated to this ball club. Showing up during the season is not always easy, opening the doors to a big league clubhouse and trying to get to know your teammates. The best way to get to know them is to go out and produce.
And he misses again, ball three.
You could pretty much book it that a fastball's coming. A challenge fastball right here. He cannot allow the nine-hole hitter to get on base with the top of the order looming.
The 3-1 pitch. And he lays off ball four. So now the potential winning run is aboard at first.
Now batter, number 29.
So the lineup flips over and digging in, Gio Urshela has got a chance to end this one and send these fans home happy if he can get a ball deep enough into the gap. I had him lunging at that one out of the zone, and that's strike one.
Ew, is that ugly? You could probably throw anything out there to this guy. He'd swing at the rosin bag if you throw it up there.
Now a drive to right field. This could do it. Game over. Walk-off home run. So it's a two-run shot to right center, and with one swing of the bat, this ball game is over.
Hey, when you get into extra innings, you're always looking for that one guy to step up and be that hero. And this guy was the hero tonight. What does he do? Steps up with a walk-off home run to end this thing in extras.
And the Yankees offense was led in large part by this man, Brett Gardner. Take a snapshot of that. He's our top player of the game.
Multi-hit game, and one of them was a dinger. That's a solid day's work for any hitter, and it had an impact on the outcome of this game.
What else can you say?
This one comes to a close today at an 8-6 final. New York with a division-leading 60th team win this year. Adam Ottavino earns his third win of the year in relief. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over.